You are the mighty God, thy great power. Alleluia, alleluia. You are the mighty God, Alleluia, Alleluia, Alleluia. We sent up as true as you are, so as you are, yeah. You will never change. Ancient of peace, as good as you are, as good as you are. You will never change. Most righteous God, we bless you. We appreciate you for your grace. We thank you for another movement. We thank you for what you promised us this week. Father, be lifted up in the name of the Lord Jesus. We thank you for what you promised to do in this month, a month of outstanding fruitfulness. Father, be lifted up in the name of the Lord Jesus. As we are going into your word, Holy Spirit, with silent flesh, in the name of the Lord Jesus, come and speak your mind. Come and reveal yourself to us. In the name of the Lord Jesus. In the name of the Lord Jesus. Magnify your holy name. In Jesus' mighty name we pray. Let's have our seat. Fruitfulness is not a new thing in the scripture. When we are talking about the fruitfulness, is what God ordained for man. If we write from the book of Genesis, the book of the beginning, the book that gives us account of how God created the heaven and the earth, we will discover that fruitfulness is what God created us with. We will discover that fruitfulness is what God loves. It is mindset of God. Equally, I can say it's a predestiny that it is predestined of all human. So it's not a new thing. When we find it in the book of John, and God now said, no, this month is a month of what? Outstanding fruitfulness. And when we're now talking about fruitfulness, we are not talking, when we are talking about outstanding fruitfulness, we are not talking about, maybe I would use the word excess. Maybe I use the word that something that now is now become unusual. Not outstanding. Outstanding fruitfulness means that unusual fruitfulness, uncommon fruitfulness. I can even say it is undeniable fruitfulness, because when people see it, they can't deny it. What has he done? What has he achieved? It's undeniable. Because it will be visible. When we're talking to outstanding, it's something to stand out among the other. So when God is promised us outstanding fruitfulness, He's promised us something precious, something glorious, something special, something unique, something glamorous. What's another English? Something splendorous. Something that reveals the glory. You know, if somebody, why is it, maybe I should ask a question, why is it that if somebody give to take God bless, no one with God bless for child, God bless, God bless, when somebody give birth to it, why is it the president or governor of the state will take in charge that they, I'll do what, I'll give them scholarship, or I'll finance them. Why? Because their fruitfulness is outstanding. They are expecting one or two. That is that when you give birth to a child, a one child, people, they will rejoice that you are fruitful indeed. So the name you name that child, that the name will be bear. But if you are giving birth to one child all the time, and all of a sudden you give birth to twins, because that fruitfulness is what we call outstanding also, what is going to happen? They will not even call you, maybe you call them Daniel and David. They will not call you Mama Daniel and David. Even the name that the child you have given birth to before, that I'm living with, that they'll be calling you Mama Kevin before, as I'm expecting twins from Mama Kevin now. They are calling Mama Kevin before. They will not call you Mama Kevin, they will call it Iyai Beji. Why? Because that fruitfulness is outstanding. So when it comes to triplets, when it comes to the quadruplets, I mean, what do we call it? Whatever, in a rainbow. When you come down, what is it going to happen? Government will not say, oh God, I will take in charge, I will give you scholarship, because it's extreme, it's outstanding. So when God is promising you outstanding fruitfulness, he's not talking about usual fruitfulness. Though indeed the way you are predestining us, he predestined us to be fruitful. But the fruitfulness we are talking about outstanding is that in a special way. And when I'm saying it, I don't want you to leave it to money alone. I don't want you to leave it to material thing alone. No. It starts from spiritual thing. Because the spiritual control the physical. So when God is talking about outstanding fruitfulness, he's talking about that both spiritually, physically, financially, materially, academically, maritally, what else? In all areas, that will be fruitful. Do you know if someone is barren in the issue of health, you don't have sound health, and you have millions in your account, is of useful. Because when they are taking that bed to hospital and hospital, they will be spending that money. Even that sickness, that barrenness of sickness in his life, can cause that person that can squander all the money, can chop all the money. So, but God is not promising you a fruitfulness in one side. We're talking about outstanding fruitfulness. It's meant in all areas. So, in your spiritual life, when you see, oh, you are bearing fruit, we see, we discover that you are growing spiritually. You become a mighty tool in the hands of God. And your finances did not go down. You know, in this generation, you are going to report you have a lot of sets in the Christianity. There are some people, they are just after the materialism. And in that place, they are flourishing, or they are being fruitful in that area alone. And there are some people, they are spiritual, only spiritual things. When you are talking about anything that I have to do, you have to sow seed, you have to do this, you have to do this business, you have to do something, all they know is just prayer. Hey, no. Blessing. Breakthrough. So what they ought to do, because God says, I'm the one that do all this, that turn your hand to earn profit. So there's some set of people, they have become listeners because what? They gave their life to Jesus. They become listeners. The right assignment that they ought to do. And the Bible said, those that not work, do not what? Do not eat. So, and because of that, they are now poor in finances and other area. And if you are poor materially or financially,
it can even affect your head. So God didn't promise that I will just bless you in one area alone. No. All the area bring glory to God. If you being rich and you are true child of God, it brings glory to who? To God. If you have standing, assuming that I'm sick now, which I call barrenness, because my body, God doesn't seek. God wants peace and sandy head here. So if I'm barren of sandy head now, what happened? Sickness take place. Please, can I be able to stand before you and preach effectively? Because I'm barren something at that junction. So I can't be useful in the hand of gospel. But when God is promising expanding fruitfulness, He's talking that in all area, you do what? You will be fruitful. And that's the reason why I wrote in the pastor corner, I said, to be fruitful is to function according to the purpose of God. Why am I saying this? Let's go to the book of Genesis chapter 1 verse 28. I want to see it very well. So it's not that way. I just bring any word. You know the textual passage that we're using? Is the book of John chapter 15 verse 16. So, but I want you to see something in the beginning. When God created a man, what did God say to them in that place? Listen to it. And God blessed them. How did He bless them, man? God sent unto them. Hello, what did God say? So it is the plan of God for you to be fruitful. It is there in the beginning. Not only be fruitful, anything that fruitful, something will happen to it. Read number. Not just to be fruitful and multiply. Multiply is talking about outstanding. Hello? Do you get that message very well? Bible God said be fruitful, but don't stop and think of being fruitful. You give your life to Jesus. Yes, you are a choir. We love that. Or you are playing drama. You love that. But oh, you are choir. You love that. But go beyond that. You can be a gospel singer, but you start somewhere. And if you be a gospel singer, let's assume. Let me talk you about. Let's understand outstanding fruitfulness. Let's say you are a member of this church and you are a song leader in this church. So you are being fruitful because you are using the gift God has given to you to bless the church of God. But if you now multiply to become a gospel singer, I'm not just the entertainment gospel singer, because there are some people now, they are entertainment singer. They are not a gospel singer, because a gospel singer must receive message from God to pass across. And that is why the song of this woman, I've never died since then. That good woman. Odun lo so pin o baba rere fi so re so wa o tomo tomo ohun ti o pa ni lekun o lodun tuntun ma je ko sele si wa o baba rere. You know the reason why that song is not expire, because I strongly believe it is a divine inspiration from God. Another one, baba ayewa adelaku. You remember that song? Baba Yewa Adelokun, when he talking about the Elkori. Amono tete wa o, amono tete bo. Ayem baje o, amono tete bo. Taru o, amono tete bo. Because it's an inspiration from God. It's a message from God. That song is still relevant now. Those hymns that you are reading is still relevant, because okay, let me now come to where I'm going. I'm just talking about a true gospel singer. He received revelation from the scripture. He received revelation from God to pass it across. So now, as I'm talking now, if you are now become a gospel singer, you see beyond being a choir in the church. And God has ordained for that. Let's assume that you now do a record. Now look at the number of people that will listen to it. People that not even see physical. Like I'm not telling you, I'm saying now, I'm not telling you about be whatever we say it now. Even in abroad, some people are listening to it. Even though that don't know Yoruba.
Because I see many of you here that didn't know your Bible, you singing now when I'm singing it. It's Igbo that's talking now. You get the cassette. Do you see?
Why? That's what we are talking about. That's outstanding fruitfulness. Among all that gospel singer, your song is different. Your song is bringing down the glory of God. It's revealing the power of God. That's what we are talking about. Both physically, financially, and spiritually. So, in the beginning, it is part of your life. It's reorganized, ordained for you to be fruitful. So, if you are not fruitful, it means that something is wrong somewhere. You need to go back to the church. Amen? It means that you need to go back to the source. Because that Bible says, and God bless them. And say what? Be fruitful. He didn't mention but no spiritual fruitfulness. No. He didn't mention physical fruitfulness. No. He didn't mention material fruitfulness. But he's talking all areas. In what? In all areas. That's what God is talking about. After the fruit and you take it to the level, don't limit yourself as the fruit. Tell me, I want you to say, great Pastor Daniel, you are multiplying in the name of the Lord Jesus. I didn't say tell yourself, you hear me, obedience first before the other. Say, Pastor Daniel, prepare. You are multiplying the grace of God.
Guru, am I worried?
Because I've ordained to be fruitful. I have ordained to be multiplied. But God don't want to remain at the level of fruitfulness alone. That's what outstanding. That outstanding. That is the adjective. Or adverb is adjective. That outstanding. No, adjective. That word outstanding is talking about multiplication of fruitful. He qualified that fruitful. Outstanding fruitfulness. He's talking about multiplication. You will multiply in the name of Jesus. How can you be fruitful? You give your life to Jesus. And now, after you give your life to Jesus, you devoted to the word of God. You know the word of God. You go out to win souls. That's what is win souls. What are you doing? You are multiplying. Spiritually, the grace of God, and you are not limited, you are not also doing something. But most of Christians nowadays, the level they give their life to Jesus, that's the level they remain. Because even to study the word of God, our energy, our power rely in what? In word of God. Even to study it become an abomination to us. It becomes a difficult assignment. Some people is Sunday to Sunday. Some people is Wednesday, Sunday, Wednesday, Sunday. And some people is a monthly. Because some people will even bring the Bible to church. They will not even open it. Some will even forget their own. Have you? Some will not even bring their own. Some will not even get. Where are you going to draw your energy? Where are you going to draw your power? Where are you going to draw your strength? You get it. As I'm going on. So, and I said that when God created man in the beginning, he prayed for them to do what? To be fruitful. Any man that is not fruitful, it shows that his function below God's standard. Because when God created them, he said what? Multiply. Be fruitful. So if I'm not fruitful, it means that I'm operating below the standard that God has placed me. As from this moment, I see you being fruitful in the name of Jesus. Not just fruitfulness, outstanding one in the name of Jesus. So number one thing you must know about yourself before you can be fruitful, you must know that you have been programmed to do what? To be fruitful. That's what Genesis chapter 1 verse 20 says. You must know that. If you don't know that, it may be difficult for you. Because what you don't know, you don't use it. So I want you to understand something. God himself is not happy when we are not being fruitful. It didn't bring joy to God. It did not bring any gain to God. We are learning at Sunday school this morning. Our Papa was telling us that Jesus left the throne of glory. He became poor for you and I to become rich. He didn't talk about money alone, but he's talking about in every area. Though some preacher may be limited to the issue of money alone, but he's talking about all areas, because they are talking about the issue of money there. But Jesus didn't leave his throne because that you may have money alone. No. That's why the Bible says, and how God anointed Jesus, and he go about and begin to do what? Doing wonder. He begin to heal, deliver. He's been fruitful. He rest leaders. And after him, the apostle. What we not even record in the day of Jesus. The Bible says, and the apostle Peter alone, he preached in a day and 3,000. What a wonderful multiplication. 3,000 gave their life to Jesus. What a wonderful multiplication. I see that same power rest upon your life this morning in the name of Jesus. Indeed, how will a Christian be doing business and will not be multiplied? When God said, whatsoever you lay your hand, you will prosper. Do you know the meaning of being prosper? Prospering is talking about fruitfulness, enlargement. He said, whatsoever you lay on that, so your business, God expects you to do what? To be fruitful. But I see that anointing resting upon your business in the name of Jesus. Amen. Get it right. So if a man did not be fruitful, he didn't bring any gain to God. Are you agree with me? And that's the reason why the Bible says, when Jesus was going with his disciples, he saw a fig tree. He went there to pluck fruit. When he got there, that tree was fruitless. May you not be fruitless to the Lord Jesus. Amen. Do you know what Jesus said? He caused the tree to dry. Because that tree is not ordained like that. How will you be a Christian and you remain at the same level when you are giving your life to Jesus? God wants you to grow into the image of his son. That's why the book of Matthew chapter 5, Isaiah 48, he said, be perfect as what? As your heavenly father is perfect. It's a gradual process. It's a good fight of faith. It's a rugged thing. You continue to do it day by day. That I want to be like Jesus. Like that song say, Mufe kinda bi Jesu ninuwa pele kuseni borobinu lenure lekori. The man that says, Mufe kinda bi Jesu. But the woman didn't say that because of that I should not prosper. He is telling us that way. That's why as I'm struggling to be, I have not been. So I'm still working toward the perfection. That's the meaning of that song. So, but most of us, we have misunderstood that through this. Okay? No one like Jesus. No one can be like Jesus. No. God never said that. He said, you should work. Be perfect. As your heavenly father is perfect. So I said, number one, you must know that you have a program. Number two, you must know that God is not happy when you are not what? You are not being fruitful. You must know that. God is not happy. And how can you ordain this? Let's go to the book of John. So John chapter 15. Read verse 1 for me. Verse 1. Is anybody there? Nobody in John chapter 15? Verse 1, read. Let's read from English version, please. He said, I am the true vine. And my father is what? His husband dresser. He said, any branch in me that do what? Listen to that. Any branch in me that do not bear fruit. What did God say? Oh God, do you see that? God said, we will take it away. Sit down, man, for a moment. Do you see now that God is not happy when you don't bear fruit? Either physically, spiritually. He didn't bring joy to God. He said, anyone that didn't bear fruit is what? He said, he shall take it away. We shall cut it off. Okay, let's continue. Read number. I want you to listen to that very well. That's number three. So, and any branch that what? That beareth fruit, it what? It prune it, it project it, it prune it. Listen to me. Sit down. Do you see? God don't want you to remain. God don't want you. That's number three. God don't want you to remain at the level of fruitfulness again alone. He wants you to do what? To multiply. Listen to that. Say any tree that is bearing fruit will be pruned. That what? That will bring more fruit. So obviously, that one is bearing fruit before. Am I saying something this morning? Is God using me this morning, or I'm using myself? Okay. So I don't even get what I'm trying to say. Is there any tree that any branch rather that now bearing fruit? God don't want it to remain at the same level alone. He said he will prune that tree that will do us, will bear more fruit. Do you know what you are doing this morning? God is pruning you. But yet, some of us will remain at the same level. Anytime we come to church, we come to say, God, is there any area that I have said that need to be cut off? In order for me to be more fruitful in every area. When the message of God is coming to you, he's pruning your life. But in many times, some people will see it as an offense. But it is me that pastor is talking about. Instead of him to check himself and say, God, what is wrong in my life? This message is talking to me. And why am I behaving in that way? Help me, Holy Spirit. I don't want to do it again. I want to press forward. But instead of that, you begin to wage war against the minister. Thank God that is not happening in our church. But it's what used to happen. It's prune. And I see God prune you to have outstanding fruit there this much in the name of Lord Jesus. So number three is that way God wants you to remain at the level of just being fruitful, but want to go to the what? Multiplication. That's what that verse is telling us. He has been a fruit before. But to do what? He will prune him to do what? To have more fruitfulness. Number four. You must know that you cannot bear fruit except you connected to him. Because I am the what? The true vine. And my father is what? Husband dresser. He said, branch. Is when you read further, Jesus is telling you that he is the vine. You are the branch. So if you are not connected to him, you can never be fruitful, neither multiply. If you want to be fruitful and multiply at all, it will be you in the tree of death. And that's the reason why, when we are talking about that, you can see all those politicians, they can do anything, they will have money. You see that fruitful, but you know that, you yourself, you know that. Nobody need to tell you, you know that this is of devil. Because how will I have billions and now store it into the tank? And it will be getting rotten, and people will be in the street, be dying. It's because the fruit I'm being bearing is not from the branch of Christ. If not, I will have known that every resource that comes to me is not meant for me, it's meant for order. I am a manager of that resources in order to do what? To show charitable equity. That's why to do that. I will not partnerize. No. And money for me, I think about the same, but nothing they could do. No, if I'm not going there, there's nothing they can do. No! Your gifts, my gifts, is for Christ. Read verse 3. Listen to that. I told you the other time, that way, the prune I'm talking about. It's like the word I'm talking to you now. Listen, say, now you are clean. You are being pruned. Why? Through the word which I have spoken unto you. Abide in me. It's okay. So there's no way that you can bear a good fruit and multiply except you connect to Jesus Christ. And the word you are hearing this morning is like a salt that will prune you. The one that I've had before is like a what? A sword that has pruned you. The one that I'm going to hear in the future is a sword that will do what? Prune you. The word of God. So, yeah.
Oh, that pastor, Adegba. Thank God, the Baptist, our man, pastor, we had one that.
No.
No. No.
You will be fruitful in the name of Jesus.
So, in answer, until you are in me. So, for you to be fruitful, the number one thing you need to do is to do what? To give yourself out to Jesus.
That book of Matthew says, seek the kingdom of God and what? And his righteousness.
And every other thing, financially fruitfulness. Every other thing, maritally fruitfulness. Every other thing, academically fruitfulness. Every other thing, materially fruitfulness.
He said, it shall be added to you.
The first thing you need to do if you want to be fruitful in life is to connect back to the source, because Jesus is the source.
Do you want outstanding fruitfulness? Go back to the source. And ready to be what? To be pruned.
Ready to allow your flesh to die. Ready to allow your flesh to deal with by the word of God. Because that's why the God pruned. Because every flesh wants to take lead. But you must know that you are man. When you say you connect to God, you are a man of spirit. Flesh must not live again. Spirit must lead. So, and that is why you must allow your flesh to be dealt with through the word. That's what we call prune. Prune. That's what we call prune. Let me say this, may look somehow to you. And may say somehow. Anyone that are not bearing fruit is like a cursed tree.
You know, when we are talking about salvation this morning in the Sunday school, and when somebody has a question, I took out the book of John chapter 3 verse 17.
You will remember that in verse 18, he said, anyone that have not believed in the Son of God is already condemned. He didn't say he will condemn them. They are already condemned. So anyone that is not bearing fruit also is the same way. Is already what? Condemned. Because he said, you are neither hot in the book of Revelation, neither cold. He said, I'll do what? I'll pour you out. God hates unfruitfulness.
Do we need usher this morning? Okay.
God hates what? Unfruitfulness. Because everything he created them to multiply.
And that's why we put a corn into the ground. What's going to happen to that corn?
It will decay first. Isn't it? After decay, it will now what? It will now germinate. And after it germinates, it will grow. It will bring flour. Isn't it? And after that, it will now bring a bunch of corn.
I know some will bring two, some will bring three.
Can you view it, a corn, how many produces that will produce? Just a corn. When you take a pot of a corn, take two. If you want to cast it, how many are you going to see it? But it's just one seed.
That's what called multiplication. God told Isaac,
stay in that land. And do what? You'll be fruitful. So when you do what? When you are connected with him, to God, to fruitful, the number two thing that must happen is that we obedience. Anyone that wants to be fruitful, what? What? Must obey. The book of Isaiah chapter 1 verse 19 says, if you are willing and what? And obey, you do what? You eat the fruit. Before you can eat the fruit, you can produce the fruit. And when you get to verse 7, read verse 7 from the book of John chapter 15 for me. Verse 7, what do you say? If you abide in me, it means that if you remain connected with me. What do you want abide in you? And my words, that word that bring you, and that flesh silence, that word not become a spirit in you, because he said in the book of John, he said the word that spoke to you is what? It's a life. When that life is in you, That will become life in you. And that word is one that will not driven you. That's the word called obedience. It's not driven you. That word of God is not driven you. Anything you ask then. Why? Because at that junction you are not reaching as a man of flesh. The reason why you are asking me that you don't receive it is because you are asking, we are praying amiss. The book of James says so. We are asking to do what? To aggravate our flesh. He said you pray but you receive not, but you, because you do what? You pray amiss. But if that word is in you, and I'm thinking, you think like a God. You think like God. Because your mind, your idea is come from heaven. You discover that you are not a citizen of this world. You are a heavenly citizen. You are an ambassador here. Your thinking will be of things that is happening in heaven. Your thinking will be of the revelation that comes from above. And when you ask, consign what is happening above, that what is happening above that they want it to happen in heaven. When you ask in that or that way, God will handle it. Let me give you an example. In my revelation through the grace of God, I strongly believe that the Bible says Anna has been going to Shiloh for several years. But one particular year, he prayed according to what his heaven is crying for. She prayed. She said, Lord, give me this child, and I'll do what? I will return it back unto you. And at that moment, everyone is looking for who is going to replace Eli's children. Because God has won, and Eli's children are not bearing the fruits that God is expecting. And that's not making to function in their destiny as a priest. When you are not bearing fruit, when you are not connected to God, you cannot manifest the destiny upon your life. They cannot function in their office because they don't bear the fruit that God is expecting. They are not multiplying. They are not bearing the corruptive seed. And Anna was praying, pray, God, I'll give that to you. I said, God, look at it. I think God checked the room and said, this woman will do that. And each time, what did God watch? God gave her somewhere. And Samuel now replaced. Because that's what heaven is praying. He reasoned according to the heaven at that moment. Until you saw, I don't know, maybe the prayer you used to pray before. Lord, you see Paulina is my second wife. Why did you give her children? And I'm not giving children. All those ones are just for your flesh. But when he prayed, God, I'll give that to you. He goes, oh, good. I'll see where I'm going to fall from. May you not miss it in life. In the name of Lord Jesus. Many of us, we are on that scatter because we are living the source of the fruitfulness. Let's check it in the book of Psalm. Psalm 1. Listen to what God is saying. Psalm 1. Is somebody here? Let them read from King James Version, please. I'm sorry. Blessed is the man. He said, blessed is the man that what? That walketh not in what? Can you get what I'm saying? What make you not to walk in the counsel of the godly? Prune what? Continue. Why is he not standing in the way of sinner? The prune word that have come to his life. Read on. Why is he not sitting in the seat of sinner? But most of all, we will enjoy that seat. Even he got to the point that we will turn the church of God to that seat. We will have a comedian who will come to the podium like this and will be saying, the energies that Jesus said, yeah, and we'll be laughing in the congregation. Seat of mocker. And when Mary come out, Mary came in, and the Christian, dead Christian, will be laughing. Spiritual thing, you turn to laugh at this. What is this food that God is requiring from me and you? Listen, until we are pruned, listen to what is really continue. Why is he not doing that? Where is he delights? In the Lord of God. All what is controlling his life, all what is guiding his life is what? In the word of God. The Bible says he do what? He meditate on it. Say it now. Day and night. What did God now said? Listen to that. That's why I say God, he showed more concern about your fullness. He said, if you can be pruned by the word of God, if that word of God can be guiding you, it means you connect to God, and whatever you ask shall be given unto you. The Bible now said that only you will be like a tree planted beside river. What did he say? Yes, in church money. He said you will bring forth your fruit in due season. Do you say that? But he said the leaf will not wither.
Do you see now?
Because he connect to the source. May you connect back to the source.
Oh.
My people. God desire in your fruitfulness. He wants you to multiply. But you must see Jesus. We shall continue next week. Let's be on our feet. Are you discovering that you have not been fruitful the way I expected? And you want to rededicate yourself back to Jesus? You want to connect back to Him? I want to raise up your hand this morning. You want to come back to Jesus? You discover that the way you have fruitfulness, you remember there are some things, certainty that is responsible for it. I said, God, I don't want this thing again. I think it's this thing. But I want to come unto you. I want you to help me. So I'll be able to have that outstanding fruitfulness that you are expecting. I have heard your word. Your word has proven again. I'm rededicating myself to you. Let that person raise up his hand. At all eyes, raise up your hand. Thank God for those hands. Thank God for those hands. Thank God for those hands. I want to offer those hands. Thank God for those hands. All those that raise their hand, you are going to sit on it. I surrender all. I surrender all. Unto Jesus, my Savior, I surrender, oh Father, in the declaration of these people, they said they have come back unto you, they surrender all unto you. They said they are reconnected back to that true fire. They don't want to separate from you again. Your word has fooled them. Therefore, as they are doing their own part, your part for them is to be fruitful. Therefore, cause them to be fruitful in the name of Jesus. Yes. That anointing for fruitfulness and multiplication, that anointing for outstanding fruitfulness, visually, financially, materially, academically, and in all areas, receive it now. As from today, Jesus said, whatsoever you ask shall be given unto you. As from today, everything called barrenness is your life. It's hereby ceased in the name of Jesus. It's hereby ceased in the name of Jesus. As from today, you shall see a shower of blessings. It shall flow upon your life. You will be soaked by the blessing of God. In the name of the Lord Jesus, pull your hand down. Run away from sin. Let's sing this song. Open the floodgate of heaven. The floodgate of heaven. Have you? Come and take microphone. You are here and you know how to sing. That's what we are talking. Who's where we are talking? That's it too. Oh.
And cause your hand to fall on me, Baba, oh, Baba, oh, oh, Baba, oh, open the floodgates in abundance, and cause your
to pray the rain of Holy Spirit. That's what we call Daniel. the reign of Holy Spirit, the reign of Holy Spirit that will cause me to bear outstanding fruitfulness, rest upon my life now.
Start to pray in the name of Jesus. Oh, you mimi ma. You are taking so and so. You are tired. Oh yeah. Shall we do sorry, my boy? In the name of Jesus. Yes, yes. We are talking about the baptism of Holy Spirit. The reign of Holy Spirit. Yes, yes. That will cause outstanding fruitfulness. Shout upon my veins. Shout upon my soul. Shout upon my home. Shout upon everything I have to consign with my life. In the name of Jesus. Can you talk to God? Yes, God Father. Thank you, Jesus. In Jesus' mighty name we pray. As we are going this week, the grace of God is sufficient for you. The power to maintain the connectivity with God will rest upon your life in the name of Jesus. No power, no kingdom will be able to separate from the branch and from the vine, which Jesus is in the name of Jesus.
Do very well. You can do more. I want to cry to the Lord again and say, Father, carry my burdens for me. Oh, go ahead, talk to the Almighty God. You are the burden bearer, oh Lord. Carry my burdens. Carry my burdens for me, Lord. You are the burden bearer, Lord. You are the burden bearer. Carry my